Let's go out now and go to our live cam on the road to see how Sam Newman's faring up. What's happening with Sam?
Roland, oh, Admiral dear, we're meant to turn right up here. We're late.
Will you get over, Sam? You've had it for days. Get off my back.
You wish.
Still looking for Sam Newman. We might just see if there's an update on Sam's location at the moment. Sam, where can we find him?
Go, Roland, turn right. We're late.
I can't. It's a red light.
It's a hook turn.
What turn?
Admiral, don't get excited. It's not a hooker's turn. It's a hook turn. Go.
Oh, I don't understand.
Let's see if I can help you. You'll love this.
What?
I'm really disappointed he's not here.
Yeah. Well, he's not too far away. We might just do another update to see how Sam's coming along. Sam, are you around there?
This is preposterous, you sitting there like a toad. Get out and give me a hand.
Well, you didn't want a hand when you were going downhill. Anyhow, you wanted to show me how strong your little legs were.
Oh, bugger it, I've broken a nail. Do you know a good manicurist?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome over by the bar for the fourth year, of course, joining us, Trevor Marmalade. Gunny Trevor.
It only seems like three to some people, doesn't it? It's unbelievable.
It does indeed to some of the kids.
And I'm looking good. Got the new haircut for the start of the season. Jace recommended a place to go to. It's a good joint called Cheap Smokes.
But mate, congratulations on the new bar.
It is absolutely splendid.
What do you think, ladies and gentlemen, the new bar?
Absolutely magnificent. In fact, I haven't actually seen it from the front. Do you mind if I just take a quick peek?
Come around, have a look there. You've got the beautiful North Melbourne.
It's looking absolutely fabulous. I mean, we have arrived in
town. You bloody idiot, Roland! You idiot! I've sat there watching your little ass wobble from side to side for 42 blocks. You still can't get it right, boy.
You're the one who's fooping around, not me.
I'll fuck you around in a minute, you
Roland,
bloody great quince.
Shut up, I'll break your nose.
Look, he's looking for a new shaver. I just want to know what it's like to work under Sam.
For most of the time, it's hard. That's it.
One of the great movies that is up for grabs, up for the Oscar, up for the best Oscar is Geoffrey Rush's Shine, the fantastic Australian film. But here is one scene that you might not have seen by going to the Oscars or going to the pictures to see Shine. Here's our version.
Some said he was a genius. Others said he was mad. To most, he was just a very naughty boy. See Sam Newman in Shiner, a film no tradesman should miss.
Why wouldn't Nick let the players come on, the new players?
Doesn't matter, because the footy show knows how to get over all obstacles. We have got our own spy cameras in. Let's have a look at the main arrivals for the West Coast Eagles. Here's Ilya Grgic, of course, a 25-year-old. This is when he was playing at Footscray. Played 62 games with Footscray. Let's go to the next one. The new player is Trent Cummings, 23-year-old. He played 27 games with Fitzroy. That's actually Scott Cummings, but this is as close as we could possibly get to it. He's no relation, but he got the same surname. This is Josh Wooden. Josh is 181 centimetre, 18-year-old from New South Wales, ACT, under 18, he's pretty tough and a long-kicking defender. This is Michael Gardner. 197 centimetres, 17-year-old ruckman from Claremont, number one draft pick obtained as a compensation for losing Ian Downsborough to Port Power. This is Michael Braun from the Bendigo Pioneers. 18-year-old, 173 centimetre midfielder who represented Victorian country in last year's national championships. And this is Nicholas Stone. He played in Claremont's 1996 premiership side. So, Sam, it didn't matter, Trip.
Yeah, I'm very glad Brett Hedy wasn't a new arrival.
I got
Well, I can say, boys. Eddie, it's lucky that Ansell didn't sponsor them. They'd be the first, first club to be wearing a rib jumper. Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right.
Here I am, stuck in the middle with you. With any alacrity, did you attack the rest of your football career or your rest of your life, in fact?
That's very funny, Sam. You're going to amuse me before this evening's out, aren't you?
Sam, wait. It's just a rule. You don't manhandle the umpire. I mean, they're full of germs and disease.
What would Linda Lovelace be doing at July?
Oh, well, that makes sense. So they don't choke on the big ones. And
we've been talk about Stan's position at St Kilda. Yep. And I believe he's safe as houses down there, especially if the houses are in Hebron.
Thanks for showing us that exclusive footage of your butt on the show last week. My mother was very annoyed that I showed my butt on the show.
I can imagine.
This was the first time we've ever seen you with a 50-year-old date.
Not too sure about my playing history after this.
Kevin called when he got the word. He said, I suppose you heard. We're playing in Alice. When we rushed to the airport, caught the first plane out, I could hardly believe my eyes as we pulled in to Alice Airport. Well, I don't know if he'll play me, don't know what he's gonna say. I guess he's got his reasons, but I just don't wanna know. 'Cause for one whole year I was sitting on the bench with Sheedy. Sheedy, Mr. Kevin Sheedy. One whole year just sitting on the bench, trying to help Bomber, trying to fix the defense. But that one whole year just listening to the shit from Sheedy. Sheedy. No, I'll never get used to not listen to the shit from Sheedy.
Last week, so you think they'd win. What do you think, Fig Jam?
Paul was saying a little bit earlier before we cut live into your fabulous studio that Plugger at the moment is playing like a fat idiot.
By the way, where's Trev gone?
Sorry, mate.
Oops, sorry, just had to have a mic adjustment.
Thanks, Mike.
I would like to hear a few words from you. This is from Russ Clark. Well, here's a few words. Russ, pick them at random. Cretin, moron, dick. You absolute loon.
But Buckley's kicking into the 50 has been sensational. In fact, he had 13 precise deliveries inside Collingwood's 50 metres last week, which is a sensational total. 13 to a bloke inside the 50, and Collingwood...
Go on, Ed. Now, let me get some stats.
And despite having less kicks than most opposition sides, yeah. Collingwood have got it into their 50 more times than any other 50. Side in the competition.
Well, they are big stats, Ed. Collingwood, what a marvellous side they are. Let's write all those down. Yeah.
And I must say, Sam, at your age, it's good to see you've got that much lead in your pencil.
Yeah. Go on, just go on undeterred. I'll just keep going. Hey?
He's having a fitness test tomorrow, by the way.
All right, then.
Okay, don't worry about that. That rub it and might poke my eye out for me. In the meantime, on Sunday...
Take your hand off it, Ed.
Trev.
Yeah, well, you should see the size of his sharpener.
Ugh.
welcome. You'll find it very comfortable here, just like some of your former coaches. I'm sure the padded cell is to your liking.
Dr. Forrest, dial
1. Yibbity yibbida, get a load of that running style. Reminds me a lot of Michael Johnson in Atlanta. Brucey.
Michael Johnson, yes. Best time of 19.32, wind assisted, muscles glistening, lycra bulging. Absolutely special.
Oh, I'm sorry, Malcolm, the bus is full.
That's the most pathetic bus I've ever seen.
Hearty souls there, the proud supporters, and what a weekend it has been for poor old Malcolm Blight. He's been in all sorts of trouble, but let's cross now to Adelaide and catch up with Malcolm Blight. And Malcolm, it must have been a pretty tough week for you.
I can get this thing in my ear. I can see Eddie Maguire, he's talking to me. He obviously doesn't realise I can't hear him. I can't hear a thing he's saying. Somebody called this thing an earpiece. This is the most pathetic earpiece I've ever seen in my life. That is absolutely ridiculous. I can't hear a thing he says. That is just ridiculous. What a lot of hooey.
Well, obviously we're having a bit of trouble there with Malcolm. Before we go on, we're right now. We've finally got Malcolm on the line. Well, Malcolm, first of all, what are you doing with the bag on your head?
Well, Ed, I said I wouldn't show my face if I got beaten by those mongrels, and I'm not going to. I couldn't hear you before. There's a bloody sound man here. He is the most pathetic sound man I've ever seen in my life. I couldn't hear. Look at the framing on this shot. Will you get me in the middle of shot? Ed, this cameraman is the most you are the most pathetic cameraman I've ever seen in my life. Somebody called this guy a cameraman. I don't know what's going on here. And this bag... Where'd you get this bag from? This is the most pathetic bag I've ever seen in my life. This is the most pathetic thing I've ever done in my life. I'm leaving. This door? Get this door replaced. That is pathetic.
Hi, I'm Trent. Feeling a bit alone and confused at kickouts? Why not call me for all the Collingwood set plays? They're all here in this unedited, totally wet and wild playbook, the one that goes all the way, like Gabbo's run. It gives you all the ins and outs and tells you where you'll find the big salve in your life. That's all for now. I'd like to show you more, but you'll have to ring me first. But hurry, this offer won't last long. Bye.
Let's go now and have a look at one of the most extraordinary interviews that we've ever seen on the Footy Show, when Sam and myself went to we stood on the mark to one of the most aggressive players, of course. He was known at St Kilda as Robbie Mad Dog Muir. And of course, Robert, the big incident that we all remember was the time that you had a go at umpire Kevin Smith. You took the old mouthguard out, you threw it down. But in all seriousness, you do like the umpires, don't you?
F***ing condom, mate. Nothing but a...
we are on national TV, mate, and it is live, So, mate, but seriously, about the umpires, they weren't all bad to you, sure.
Oh, they're all f***ing maggots.
Bobby,
I must... Get your f***ing hands off me. Rob, it'd go well with Don Scott, wouldn't it, hamburger?
We've got nowhere to go, Bobby, if he keeps f***ing. I mean, we've got to just ask...
Yo, you used to be right up the umpires, just shut up.
Look, Rob, I'm going to have to, seriously, I don't want to put you in this position. I know it's embarrassing.
Well, you want to know about the umpire? Not. He chased me around all f***ing day.
Mate, seriously, we're going to have to ask
him. Hey,
I'll
take over the show, p*** off.
mate, look, we love having you on. We appreciate you being here.
Shut up and let me tell my story. Look, you know what umpires are like? I'll call them dwarfs. It's about that big.
Right, seriously, we might have to call an end to this interview, OK? And, look, I'm sorry, mate.
If you don't want to f***ing listen for the rest of the story, you can get
This one is one, of course, that we could never forget. Other than our very own Trevor Marmalade this week was announced as the Moomba Monarch along with the one and only Essendon coach Kevin Sheedy. Let's hear it for the boys. Mate, congratulations, the Moomba Monarch.
Yes, thanks very much, Ed. I'm wearing the garb as the Moomba Monarch, and it's like there's a party in my pants and no one's logged. But in tribute to Moomba, we'd like to do a little song, and it goes something like this. You and me, can we be partners?
You and me.
Association, one that never ends.
You
and me, can we be partners? You and me, can we be friends?
Oh, the kids and mums and daddies, that's where friendship begins.
A really cheerful chappy, be like me and the king. For it's a papa thing.
All together!
It's a papa thing.
This old digger was walking down the footpath with his wife Val. And he saw coming towards him a bloke who'd saved his life in the war, a bloke called Norm. And he said to Val, his wife, "That is Norm." He said, "I haven't seen that bloke saved my life. He convalesced me for 12 months. He actually donated a kidney from his own body because I was hit with shrapnel. Nothing is too good for this man." He introduced him to Val. He said, "Val, we've got to take Norm home, cook him a meal. Nothing is too good for this guy." So Val takes him home, and I said, "Beluga caviar, Norm." He said, "Fantastic. Nothing is too good for you." So they get the beluga caviar. He said, "Do you like a drink of red?" Norm said, "Yeah, it is." "I'll go down the bottle shop," he said, "and I'll get you some
Grange.
As you would Grange. $150, but nothing is too good for Norm." So he comes back, goes to the dining room. Norm and Val aren't there. He walks into the kitchen, and there's Norm. He's astride, he's actually, as they say in the classics, Eddie, he's in the horizontal refreshment position. Right. He's mounted her.
Haven't read that. Was that Dickens or Shakespeare, that classic? But anyway.
He has mounted her.
Yeah. Okay.
And the bloke looks at the writhing couple on the floor and he said, "Val," he said, "good God, woman, what are you doing? Arch your back and get Norm's agates off those cold tiles."
The boys have sent me over a few weeks early to England to do a bit of scouting. Just arrived on the Qantas jumbo here in London to find out what we can get up to. Each year, millions of tourists come to London. Many come for the shopping, and there's one store that stands out above the rest, where if you're lucky, you may even get a chance to see the Queen. Of course, no trip to London would be complete without going down to West End to take in a show. If you're in London and you forget your watch, you can always rely on Big Ben to tell you the time. What's the time, Big Ben?
2:30, Doug.
Thanks, Big Ben. This is just unbelievable. I've only been here 5 minutes and already I'm going to see the castle. One thing you can't miss when you go to London is the changing of the guards. See you, Billy.
See you, Dougie.
Daggers.
My hair all right?
Your hair looks fine.
So you can you see my own hair?
No, your hair's all right. Don't forget to mention Crown and Qantas.
And the footy show.
Yeah, mention all that stuff. Yeah, get all that stuff in. Because we've got to win this ticket to London.
Always wanted to go to London.
No, you can't come to London, Emmy. It's only for two.
Didn't you know?
You're joking.
No.
So I'm dressing up, embarrassing myself, just for your benefit, just so you guys can go to London.
It's only for the boys.
Didn't you know?
Where are you going?
I'm not going to sit here and let yous just tape me and then yous go off without me. Be
joking. Boy, sit down. You haven't complained up until now.
Look, if I don't go to London, nobody goes to London.
Relax.
Uh-oh.
Where's she going?
Where are we going?
Relax. Oh, shit, what's that?
This is our winner for the Sam London videotape competition, flying Qantas to London.
When the footy show travels to London later next month, it'll be a tremendous opportunity for me and the boys to one, fly Qantas, and two, introduce the English folk to what our remarkable footy show has to offer. But what if they can't understand our game in using an oval bowl? Maybe you'd need skill for that. By taking the footy show over to London, we'd show the Poms through pure entertainment, with the exception of Dougie, of course. This great game of ours is by far and away the best in the world. And if anyone dares to disagree, we'll give you an evening out with Jason Dunstall. And we wouldn't wish that upon anyone.
I actually thought I must have said that somewhere and he was lip-syncing me. Because I wasn't actually paying attention until I heard my own voice.
I tell you what, it's very good, both entrants there. But there was a last-minute entrant in this week.
As long as everything's all right with you, Sammy, that's all we care about. We're happy for you, Sam. We're glad if as long as you're okay.
Oh, we're not going.
All right, Sam, so we're not going to London, mate. That's fine with me.
Where is London?
Oh, I'm in the summer. You know, I was going to have a couple of days on a Greek island, but, you know, Ballarat's looking pretty good.
That one was sent in from Piggy, Douglas, the Kid, Trevor, and the entire staff here at the Footy Show. Trev.
Yeah, looking at the other two, I think we came third tonight, boys.
Oh, Sam, how are you feeling? You've had a very nasty time, but everything's going to be wonderful. We've got a real surprise for you. Your own special playmate, and he's going to be here for the whole time.
Hello, Sam. This is going to be so much fun spending all this time together. We can chat all day. We'll have our sponge baths together. Oprah's on in the afternoon. Look, there's so many things we can do together today, you just won't have a minute to be bored. Now, wake up, Sam. It'll be okay. Look, Ricky Lake starting. Go, Ricky. Go, Ricky. Look, it'll be all right. Cheer up. We're going to have so much fun here. We can watch Eddie and the boys later on. Talking footies on.
Jason Mooney, of course, there is a bit of a reason why he got into this altercation, and this will be tabled at the tribunal tomorrow night. We have exclusive vision of what went on at the Mooney household before the game last week.
Come on.
All-Star Cafe. I've been over here examining Warnie's.
Yeah.
Get rid of him. Shove it. I'm looking over here at Warnie. Hang on, wait. This is a sports cafe. It's called boxing. Get him out of here. We're going to get rid of that bloke there. We got Warnie's wall up here. And it describes everything that Warnie... Oh, I'm feeding him guns.
Well, Dermot, so far you're still the best looking.
We got him out of there. Go away, mate. Go away. We got him out of there. Finally.
Yes, that felt good.
You can actually read about Warnie and what he did before he took the wickets of Gatting and all those things. And it's Warnie's party here. But guess what? He just thought he wouldn't turn up. He just racked off. So that's what kind of party he throws. But I have got a few of the legends with me, as you described, Eddie. We've got Nick Holland, who has the big game ahead of him with the Hawks against North Melbourne. You played them last week. The Western Bulldogs. Sorry about that. This dickhead's put me off out the back. I just want to go on with it, believe me. Now, Nick, you're looking forward to a win. The Doggies are playing well. You're coming off a loss. You've gone win, loss all year.
Yeah, it's just out of the eight, and the Bulldogs are in the eight, so it's a chance for us to advance and go 4-3.
Well, good luck. Eddie, you got any questions for the boys?
No, you've got a statement, Dermot. So far, you're still the best-looking blonde there.
We got little Shaney Crawford. We got to ask whether... Look at him getting in free plugs. He's getting a free jacket out of this. Crawford. How far off are you from coming back?
There's Roland.
2 weeks, but have a look at my suit. I got it $50 in Phuket on the footy trip.
Shane Crawford, happy Hammond. And we've got Roland, who's looking at getting into the nearest footy club that he can. Roland, you're after a footy club?
After a footy club?
Just one footy club. Just
the Fremantle Dockers.
Well, you heard it. He wants the doctors, and he wants the doctors, all right. Now, Mickey Mansfield, we got Mick here. So, guess what? I'm over with Mick, and I've got no idea what I'm going to ask
him. Dermot, you can... I've written a poem, and it's called Urinating by Shane Crawford. I have a little brother named Justin, who one night at the casino was bustin'. His mates, which they did beg, don't urinate on his leg. So instead, he did it on his head. But in my brother's defence, I must say, his head just got in the way. Collingwood, although, has another disgrace, with Jamesy peeing all over the place. Two fine young females he did hit, just as well he didn't need a... What should I put there, Sam?
Shane, when you try and pronounce your words, try a little bit clearer, please.
Just talking footy by Iron Mike and Math, Iron Mike and Brucey. They're taking us through the serious points of football, and I can recommend it. It's rating its tits off. It's rating its breasts off. It's fantastic. And I would just invite you to watch it if you can. Jason was on it, our esteemed colleague. They seemed to pinch a lot of our panel members. Gary Lyon was on it. I think James Heard was on it. And I thought last week it just fractionally started to get bogged down. And Jace, we have some footage of Jason actually on it. And just see, you be the judge. Don't let me put words in your mouth. You be the judge of it.
I'm Jace.
Thanks, Bruce.
How are you coping? Second knee reconstruction?
Yeah, not a lot of fun, I must say. But the hardest thing, I think, is trying to stay a part of it as much as you can.
The ladder. Oh, fascinating. Look at this. Cole Hutchison will be able to tell us. But have we ever had anything like it?
But I think, I must say, I think this round showed that the big boys are starting to make their
way. Who are they?
West Coast, North Melbourne and Sydney.
Yeah, I'd argue the West Coast. Would you?
I thought the conditions suited them perfectly on Saturday. Windy, scrappy conditions of Victoria Park. And I think the Eagles only, to me, look like kicking 10 or 12 goals.
Yeah, and but there's reasons for that. I mean, they're missing blokes who
kick goals. Yes, but they're not going to be sold in the immediate future.
Well, Cousins and Ball will come back, and
when?
Mitchell White may come back. Well, I reckon that Mickey Moniz was very animated on Saturday night. I think he realised it.
Oh, a bit harsh.
Hey, Ed, where's my brekkie? Spud? And don't forget, you've got to have a look at that tree out the back as well.
How you going out there?
I'm feeling a bit, frisky. Roland!
Now listen, Sam, really.
I'm sorry. Here are Percy and Dickie.
Thank you! Thanks, Eddie. Oh, it's great to be back. Well, tonight we're going to do a little medley of some of our favourite sporting songs. Ooh. And nothing more topical in football than trial by video.
I remember long ago when players went the biff, that Dermy Brereton made a big career of it.
Oh, how I miss a good old-fashioned squirrel grip.
Oh, no. Start the tape quick. Oh, no.
Mickey Martin's going apeshit.
Oh, no. Plugger's looking edgy. Oh, no. He's given Kernahan a wedgie. Neo's killed the AFL staff. I've seen better bumps with Sam Newman's car. Diesel cop 9 and Wanganeen laughed. Big John Elliott just said pig's ass. Let's go to court, I'll bring the cigars. He went ah, 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 ah.
Thank you. This is a big topical one. Drugs in sport. Always topical around the old Olympic times. Ooh. Drugs in sport.
Dum dilly lilly lum dilly, dum dilly lilly lum dilly. There's a drug you should not take, it isn't very cool.
Well, Benny Johnson tried it, started passing rocket fuel. The Chinese swimmers tried it, but the women they looked odd, with a pair of you know what's
hanging out their swimming tops. Don't take those super anabolic steroids in extra large doses,
or else they'll take your specimen and put it to their noses. They'll say there's more in this than piss. I think we'll do a dope test for super anabolic steroids in extra large doses.
Oh, and what about that fateful America's Cup purse?
The true story how we lost the old cup to the Kiwis.
Just sit right back and you'll hear a tale of a fateful boat. They call the one Australia, but the bugger wouldn't float. They spent $2 million.
They were so proud when they launched her, but they did not read the instructions. It said, do not put in water.
Well, the weather started getting rough. John Bertram said,
don't panic.
She's built by the same company who built the Titanic.
Now New Zealand's now won
New
the cup.
New Zealand's won the cup, and the glory's theirs to keep. And they said, do you reckon you'll mount the cup? He said, no, I'll stick with sheep. And finally, a little song about Carlton's favourite football family.
If you go down to the pitch today, be sure for a big surprise. You might think you're in Italy or one of the Greek Isles.
There's lots of shouting everywhere, the smell of garlic's in the air.
Today's the day the Silvanis have their picnic.
There's Mama and Papa and Gino and Johnny and gorgeous Joe Bailey.
There's Auntie Rosa and the kids
and of course Sergi.
They go for a swim and they nearly drown. It's all the gold chains holding them down today. The Silvanis have their picnic.
Well, Steve has bought a Valiant with new Venetian blinds, cos Joe is giving birth to little Sauce in 9 months' time.
To be a child would be my dream. I'd be breastfed till I'm 16. The Silvanis have their picnic.
Thank you, God bless you, bye-bye.
Thank you.
Dermot was driving along, I think it was Dandenong Road in Melbourne, driving home, decided to fill up his car. And as he drove into the local 7-Eleven there, Sam, he noticed that three guys were belting the hell out of the proprietor.
Really?
At which time a couple of them tried to run away. There's four, in fact. Three tried to get away. One ran in and tried to allegedly jump all over the guy inside the 7-Eleven, at which time the doors were slamming shut and Dermy came to the rescue, got inside the door, pulled it in.
This is fair dinkum, is it?
This is absolutely true. Apprehended the other guy. And then by that stage, they were smashing the windows in, so he let him go. But the coppers are on the case. and Dermot is a true life hero. So well done to our own Dermot Gordon. But in our endeavour to continue to find these culprits, we have done our own Crime Stoppers with Dermot reenacting the crime.
At 11 p.m. midweek in March, former AFL legend and all-round nice guy Dermot Brereton was driving down Wattle Park Road. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. It was only when Dermot pulled into a service station for a light snack that he realised something was wrong. Dermot didn't want trouble, but they pushed him too far.
Righto, just take your time, Dermot. Five, officer. Take him away, boys.
Dermot Laughing Boy Hawkins, sentenced to 3 years of speech therapy at a local primary school. Skinhead Sam Newman must attend the next 5 Geelong Grand Finals and stay for the entire game. Mel Fatty Brown was sentenced to 3 years at Jenny Craig.
Chris speaking.
Chris?
Yes.
Is Joanne there?
Yes, just a moment.
Thank you very much. This is fraught with danger, this one, I can tell you. Go on, Sam.
You there? Help Joanne? Well, anyhow, look. He's probably just going to pull her out of the rack. Well, he's got
Hello?
Joanne?
Yes?
This is Sam speaking.
Yep.
Did you write to the footy show saying that Sam Newman was a sarcastic, arrogant, idiotic, selfish, poor excuse for a human being?
Yes.
Where do you get off slagging people like that? Haven't you got any respect? You there?
Yeah.
And moreover, are you doing home tutoring? You've spelt arrogant incorrectly. And I am not a human being, I am a human being. You there?
Yeah.
You better tell us she's on air.
Oh, you're on air, incidentally. If you just tune in half an hour, Joanne, to the footy show in Adelaide, you'll see yourself.
Yes.
Now, go on, say it now on national television. Would you like to repeat it? Go on.
Repeat what?
Well, repeat what you said in the letter, or didn't you write it?
Yeah, but I forgot what I wrote.
Did your mum or dad help you write it, did they? Did Chris come down to the room and help you write it? Eh?
I wrote it by myself.
Well, obviously, I mean, you're obviously a cretin, Joanne, because you can't spell.
Why don't you get Chris on it? Give Dad a bit of a toweling.
Chris! Get your old man back. Joanne.
Yes?
Get your father back on the phone.
Okay.
Hurry up.
Oh, she's crying.
She's crying, is she?
She's only 13.
She's crying. Oh, dear, sorry.
It's only 5 years till she'll have a license, you know that?
Yes, hello. Chris speaking.
Oh, there it is.
Hello, Chris.
Yeah, how are you going?
Chris?
Yes, Chris, that's right.
What in God's name are you letting your daughter write very savage and nasty letters to the footy show for?
Oh, Sam, isn't it?
Yeah, I said it was Sam to your daughter.
Oh, right, yeah, no, it's okay, Sam.
And why don't you get her to spell properly? Arrogant is not A-R-R-I-G-A-N-T, and I'm not a human bean. I'm soaking in beans, but I'm not a human bean. Hello?
No, I didn't read the letter myself, Sam. I knew she wanted to send it, but
I didn't
vet it, no.
I'd take her down to the back room and give her a decent flogging for being stupid. All right, well, that's enough. Go away now.
We've taken Joanne out and seen Melbourne. Look, here's a little bit of a sample of what we did. We had a fantastic day. We started off. This is the Rockman's Regency. What a marvellous place there. And here's me coming up and knocking on the door. And look, there she is. Her Excellence. And she was very, very happy with that. She was delighted to see me. You can tell by that. And I was delighted to see her. Then we moved on from Rockman's Regency down to Sports Girl, who were fantastic. We decked her out there. Doesn't she look like a princess? Well, sort of a princess. And she looks fantastic there. Rockman's and Sports Girl here. There's another ensemble here. Oh, no, I was absolutely delighted to be there. And here we went to the Jam Factory and saw a fantastic film. We thought we'd sit there and loved it. I did. That was just a fantastic film. And, of course, then on for more gaiety and mirth. This was the Pièce de Résistance. Now, Jace, this is it. I want to see if you've got anything inside that puny little chest. Come over here. I'm going to give you a test over here. I told you, I've set this up during the week. Come over here. Come on.
No, away you go,
Jace. This is the great Leviathan. Hurry up. Get your shirt off. Come on. Have a look at this. Have a look at the torso. This is a man who doesn't have to play to earn money. Have a look at this. Come on. Find out a bit here. Hurry up. Well, of course,
Sam, Jason was regarded, or is regarded, as one of the strongest players in the AFL, so...
Beautiful boy. Go on, hurry up. Hurry up, Jason.
What are we doing?
I'm going to give you a simple test on this lat machine. MBF, yep. Hurry up, boy. What's wrong with that? Jeez, you're thin. Whoa!
What are we doing?
Jeez, sit down. We're going to strap you in. This is to isolate. Put your arms up. Right, now put it on. I'm going to strap this in here.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to strap it in. No, hang on, we'll do it this way.
I'm now officially getting worried, Eddie. He's tying me up.
Righto. Now, you put this over here. This is so we.
Hello!
Hey, speak into the mic. Righto. Now. Yeah, pull that down. Now this is, my God, you are a big, strong brute. That would be, a couple hundred pounds there, Eddie?
I think so, yes.
All right, don't overdo it. That's beautifully done. But you don't think I could do that. Now, did you know I have set this up for me?
That's the test.
Yeah, that's the test. Did you find that hard? All right, come on, stand back.
How about you have a go? Well, can you untie me first?
Oh, untie me. Do you know why we tie you up?
Because it's
designed for just isolating that part of the body that we want to isolate, right? No, it's all right. Jesus, it's not as easy as it looks, is it? Righto. Oh. Now.
Look like
a... the thing about it is, Eddie, it's okay to look great and actually do nothing. And earn a lot of money doing nothing, but anyone can do it. It's whether you can actually get out there and get a kick.
Well, of course, as I said, Sam, Jason is regarded as one of the strongest men in football, and, you are giving away a bit of weight and certainly a fair bit of age there, but we'll see how you go. Now, just, Jason, you have to make sure that's done because it isolates the muscles, and this is a test of the lats, as we well know.
Quite right, Eddie. We have to do it very tight, so he's only using the desired muscle group.
Now, Sam, Jason, we didn't let him go the full hog there, but he usually, pardon the pun there, Jason, but he generally does 20 reps times 3. So if we can get 10 out of you, I think you'd be doing well.
Now, hang on. Can you move anything?
No.
You're totally restricted. So nothing.
Don't worry. I won't cheat. I won't show you up. Right, do it now.
No, I don't want you to do anything. You don't think I didn't know about this at any stage, do you? You honestly think I'm going to walk in here and not know anything that's going on? Can I have my accessories, please? You have been at my hair all night.
Jason, let me give you a word of advice.
If I was to use these, it'd take all night. They're no good. And this could be all right. Don't worry about that.
I'm warning you now, Jason, this would be the silliest thing you've ever done.
Doesn't that make a
other
sweet
than,
noise?
Other than take over the captaincy of Hawthorn.
And I'll tell you what I've got. I've got someone to give me instructions on how to catch it. Can I have my assistant in here, please?
Don't tell me. No, don't do it.
Come here.
Don't
come here.
Don't. I'm telling you.
Get
don't
here.
Do don't do it.
Don't do it. Stay there. This is fantastic.
Is he doing that? Is he doing that?
Get it all up.
That is it. That's for sure.
Mate, what is Sammy? Where'd you get that top from? It looks like that plumber dropped it at the front of your house, mate.
Tell you what, Jase.
Just remember,
it's the last
Jase.
Time you appear on the show, mate.
Remember the back here. You got to leave a bit at the back, mate. Make him, you know, a bit more style to it. The only unfortunate thing is you're not sharp enough to cut into the skull. Just keep going, mate. Just a little bit at the back here. You got to leave that, you know. Let that grow a few years, Sammy. It sort of bit lengthen it. Look good for you.
Jason,
now I know what the shearers feel like. Da-da. It's real good, Sam. Just like shearing sheep. That's out, bro. Calm your head open. Leave this pick here, Jason. You know, it's looking good, Sam.
You've been part of this.
Please welcome to fill in for Sam, the man who's more Sam than Sam himself, Andrew Starton. Good on, Andrew.
Well, thanks very much, Ed. It's just a pleasure to be here. It's just an absolute dream come true to be on the show tonight, and it's just a shame Sam couldn't be here.
Andrew, before we go on, of course, the great man, he's had a bit of trouble with his nose and everything, but you must be feeling a bit sorry for him then.
Oh, no. No, I couldn't care two hoots about it. He's probably sitting there at home with his feet up nice and relaxed, but, well, he can sit there for as long as he's like. Oh, I'll take over.
OK, Bruce, it's time to pick our team. Now, we're pretty charitable here at Channel 9. Why don't you go first?
Ah, who do you pick? All absolute champions. All very special players of the game. Rexy, Sam.
Just pick Bruce.
Okay. Rex.
I'll take Sam. And I need a comedian. Think I'll have Trev.
Ah, comedian. Mike Sheehan.
Jason.
Jared Healy.
Dermot.
Bobby Davis, he's special.
James.
Timmy Watson. There's only two left, Eddie. What have we tossed for them?
Tails.
Heads it is. That laugh will never work on television. We'll take Dipper.
Okay, Dipper. Come on, then. Come on and stop playing. Yes, indeed. Dougie. I can honestly say, mate, you weren't the last pick when we were doing the footy show.
Yeah, that was pretty funny, that. Yeah.
No. In fact,
that fantastic cartoon, that Bear Naked was unbelievable.
The woof-woof for Footscray has been, Western Bulldogs, has been so successful that a lot of other clubs are following suit.
Oh, yeah? What are they doing?
From now on, after a goal, the Geelong supporters will be yelling, meow, meow, meow. The North Melbourne supporters will be yelling... The Dockers supporters will be downing tools and going for a smoko. And the Adelaide Crow supporters have been discouraged. And it's a great night at the panel tonight. Let's talk about football brains on the panel. We've got Bickleys, Buckleys and none. Are you OK now that the other relationship's over? I heard you... I heard you were a bit crushed. The footy show video, there it is. Let's have a look at the caption above Sam's head. It says, Stillwell Ford, we put people in front of cars. Sammy, his legs held together by a couple of screws, which is in direct contrast to his life. I was talking to Russell Gilbert recently, Dougie, and he said that he actually saw your last game that you played for Fitzroy, and he said in the last quarter you actually put your hand down your own pants and it was the only touch you got all day.
To miss his talent, you would have to be blind. Christopher Langford, you're one of a kind. Oh.
I just wanted to say to any concerned viewers at home, there will be no poem about Tammy Van Wisser.
Now, from war-torn Bosnia to another refugee camp on the other side of the world, down under in Ballarat, Australia. The camp is being set up for the followers of a weird sect. Our man on the spot is Samuel J. Newman. What's the latest, Sammy?
Yes, Connie, I'm here on the outskirts of Ballarat, and we are expecting over these hills at any moment a swarm of flea-ridden rabbit inbreds.
Ow, Sammy!
Worse, Connie, crow supporters, truckloads of the dirty, stinking buzzards, and the Victorian people are hoping to corral them here in Ballarat before they get down to Melbourne.
Then what, Sammy?
Well, a good drenching for a start, Connie. They're worried about an outbreak of mad crow disease, particularly if they win a thing called the premiership.
Wow, that sounds nasty, Sammy. You take care.
You too, beautiful. This is Sammy J. Newman signing off for CNN.
Trevor by the bar.
Yeah, I was just wondering, have they found someone to run the camp?
No, yeah. Not yet, no.
Because quite an experienced operator flew into the country the other day. Yeah. Sorry, look, I know you're not supposed to laugh at your own jokes, but I've never heard that one before.
No problems with God's gift of warthogs.
My heart goes out to you, Sam. I was whacked at my front door once. Tell you what, don't upset the Mormons, whatever you do.
I was shattered when I heard. I mean, a lot of people probably thought I would be, overjoyed by the thing, but God, I'm a poor liar, aren't I? I've got to tell you, Sam, I laughed my guts out.
What are you doing there?
Kiss the ball.
Now I'm getting your hair off,
hey, you. I've just about had enough of you, all right? Now that's fair dinkum.
Well, Sam, we haven't really got onto the loss of license yet. What happened, mate? Just drove around till you sobered up?
You want to hope they got short memories. They might never remember you ever again.
You keep it up and you'll be a memory in a minute.
I'll stand on this table, Ed, next week with a jock strap on. If Collingwood beat Geelong.
Any chance of doing something that we'd be interested in seeing?
Now wake up, Sam. It'll be okay. Look, Ricky Lake starting. Go, Ricky. Go, Ricky.
It's an unfortunate thing for some celebrities. Some celebrities become that famous that they can't even go out. In fact, Sammy's become so famous he can't even go home.
How fortunate can anyone be just to be alive, really? That's about how it is. Is this Shangri-La? Have we died? Are we in heaven?
The steroids, don't they make the genitals shrink?
Yes.
Is that right?
Well, they have in the past, didn't
you? That's what I always say. Yeah, sorry, honey, it's the steroids.
He's taken on the chin and he's prepared to cop the punishment and come back bigger and, or better.
Now, the last time you're on, you came on and gave Sam a big kiss.
Oh, yeah. Hang on.
Well, you want another one, Sammy?
That Hyundai have bought out a bigger model, bub.
We were trying to crack on at James Packer's girlfriend there, Kate Fisher. We could all be off here.
You didn't see Derm in the background. He went by and Kate said to him, I'd like to get something off my chest. And he said, what? She said, your eyes.
She announced to her during the week, Sam, that they're bringing out a new Ford after you, Ford Newman, and it's going to have airbags on the outside.
I'm having a bad streak, let's be honest, Ed. I'm having a bad... If I fell into a barrel full of nipples, I'd come out sucking my thumb, Ed.
Oh, it's amazing the respect you get, isn't it, right? How are you, Doug?
How are you, Jacko?
Too good for you, mate.
What other words did you learn at school this year besides crap?
More.
Who?
More words.
Yeah, what more words did you learn?
I can't say them.
Go on, tell them, we'll bleep them out, we'll go beep, go on. Give us your best one.
F**k.
Would you like to sniff me?
Play with your stamen.
No, no, thank you. No, I hear other people play with your stamen.
Are you sure you haven't stolen a tea cosy there?
I made this.
Did you?
I sure did.
Shouldn't there be a hole for the spout to come out of?
What, your spout? I'm coming on the footy show. I'm coming on the footy show.
You're coming on the footy show? Gee, we'll have to get some... You're coming on the footy show? I reckon there'll be about 200 others with you.
What do you think about Mr. Busy at the tribunal? Could you have a message for him? Could you say something, Mr. Busy?
Yes, I'm busy in here.
You're busy here?
Yes.
That's a very funny line, you know?
Yes, I'm busy in here.
You're
busy
here?
Yeah, yes.
Very good. Are you a Brisbane... you're not 13, are you? You're a Brisbane Bears fan?
I'm 5.
You're a Brisbane Lions fan, are you? Do you know the Brisbane Lions?
I just come from... Hang on, I just got to ask my mum where I come from.
Where is she?
who are you barring for?
I'm an S&M man, mate.
And what's your name, mate?
Lizard, mate.
Why would they call you Lizard for?
Oh, I'll show you, Dougie.
Oh, no. Have a look at this. You must make it plenty happy with that, wouldn't you?
Oh, I love it, mate.
One more, just one more with that camera. Look at it roll out. Bending away. 8, 9, 12 inches of power. Oh, it's a monster. It is a monster of a tongue.
How you going?
I f***ing at you.
Just say hello to the man.
I don't know, like, I'm f***ing at you.
Get him away. And what do you like about the footy show, sir?
Just about everything, mate.
The weather?
That's what a cookie chook in, the weather.
I meant to say the temperature. The weather.
Can you put this hat on here and do YMCA? I don't know if you look like someone, right? You ready?
Right. YMCA. How's everything going?
Hi, how are you?
How are you?
Yes.
You're a lovely looking woman.
Thank you very much, and so are you. Bye bye.
So am I, a lovely looking woman. Oh, that's fair enough. Say polka dot.
Polka dot.
No, polka dot.
Polka dot. Black and dark. Suddenly across to the pub, black and dark, black and dark.
We'll sneak up on one of the real Port Adelaide men.
How you going there, mate?
Oh, gee.
Are you into self-abuse, are you?
Hey?
You into self-abuse?
Oh, it's lately I've been giving it a fearful pounding. Now, this is the real hub of what might go on outside the courts. Madam, you must watch.
I'm not a madam, sorry.
Because?
I said I'm not a madam, thanks.
Madam?
No, I'm not. I'm a fella, like you.
You're a fella?
Yeah. Don't want me to prove it to you, do you?
Sam, I'll bear my bum on this track if he wins this race.
Oh, I don't think we've got a wide enough lens, mate. In a girl, good. In a boy, disturbing.
Sammy, my mate, I've got to give this. Oh, Sammy. I love Sammy.
Harvey, I am resigning. All right, now. I'm going into therapy.
That thing you do, breaking my heart.
it's on my mirror. Ask anyone. Ask
Sam, great day for trading, mate.
Is there such a thing, Jack?
You going to open the door?
Am I allowed to?
Well, certainly I do.
We'll do that.
Yes, Connie, as I speak, I'm on the outskirts of Ballarat, and behind me here are the some hills.
Say behind me here are some hills and some gonna come over.
We're on the outskirts of Ballarat, and at any moment over these hills could come an onslaught of migratory inbreds and flea-ridden.
G'day, darling. What are you doing today?
I'm waiting for my boyfriend. He's just inside grabbing me some lunch.
Is he? Whereabouts? Kicker!
What are you doing?
Oh, I got no, what are you doing?
Oh, here he is.
Kicker!
Hello, Doug. You sure you didn't want something?
You could ask who that.
Hey, tell me to ask Kicker. No, ask Kicker. No, this is the last time. Hold on.
G'day there, darling. What are you doing today?
I'm waiting for my boyfriend. He's just getting me some lunch.
Oh, whereabouts is he?
Lead you
right. Who do you like starting?
I do.
Go, Ricky. Go, Ricky.
Oh, can you do? I can't do that.
If I don't watch it, I've only seen it enough.
This is just going to embarrass the shit out of me.
Hi, I'm Trent. Feeling a bit alone and confused at kickouts. Why not call me for all the Collingwood set plays? Yeah, we've got oodles. Yeah. All right, thank you, Sam. That's enough, Sam.
Oh, I love doing this. I get paid to do this. It's fantastic.
Lights, models, guest list. Just do your best, darling.
God, look, I thought we'd never start at one stage this year. I had tears running down my legs about June.
It's just a group of guys getting together, following a basic game plan, and it's pretty much making up as we go along.
I think, Justin, you've got the Crush Your Heart jocks on. Was that actually your butt, or did you have an arse double for that?
It was Jason's face.
Eddie, I'll pull my pants up now, maybe, don't mind. I've been there a neck the whole time.
Absolutely special, Dern.
And he just went bang! Wake up, Ron, this is exciting!
Sammy's a good man. I think I'm a bit old for Sammy, but it's okay.
You worry about that. As long as you're standing erect and breathing, you're a champ. The bloke looks at the writhing couple on the floor and he said, Bell! He said, good God, woman, what are you doing? Arch your back and get Norm's agates off those cold tiles.
You know what I like about their humour? It's really clever. It's really sort of, it's almost intellectual.
Get where they are. They have to.
See that? It's another one. We've won two in a row. We couldn't believe our luck. Eddie has won this personally himself. We've beaten Sports Tonight, the Sydney Footy Show, and Wide World of Sports for our second Logie on the Footy Show. Some of the folks here have, I'll be honest, have given the Pims a terrible hiding down at the back bar here, and I think we're ready to find out what the real story and secret of tonight is. So come with me and we'll check.
Is it worth anything?
Is it worth anything? You're the money man. What would you get for that? What would that be worth if you went in looking for a gig on another television station? You said, I got one of these. What would they say to you?
Piss off.
Here is a man who has won 17 gold logies. How many did you win?
None.
Did you win this microphone?
Who Dares Wins? These are the stars of Who Dares Wins. Is that on our network? Did we win any Logies at all? I don't think we won a Logie, did we? We're putting the bloody things on. You're the chief executive of the National Nine Network, David Leckie.
That's great.
Wasn't it an exciting night?
I thought it was pretty good, actually.
It was boring as bugger.
No, it wasn't.
I mean, I would wear a pink sequin dress, but not a bikini, man.
But bikini's not a babe.
Darling, not on a show with men. Are we really doing this?
They're not men, they're bastards.
What are they?
Why do blondes wear underwear?
Hey, why do blondes wear underwear?
Because to keep their ankles warm.
That is disgusting.
Hey, no. Are you Sam Newman?
No.
You're ridiculous.
Perfect match. And look, I've got a mental box. What was the other one? Come
blind
on.
Date.
Blind date. Dates Sam. And boxes and snatches. I mean, it's all got a theme, isn't it?
Yeah, it has. Nice young innocent kid sent him away for filthy weekends at the Gold Coast. How good's that?
I've actually just done Australian Playboy.
Australian Playboy?
Yes, comes out on June the 4th, so have a look.
The Playboy magazine?
Yes.
Is that right?
That's
what
right.
What have they had you in? Just swimsuit shots or...?
A bit rudy, actually.
A bit rude.
Rudy nerdy.
Really? Nerdy?
Yeah.
My God.
I'm in trouble. I am
it's
actually...
It's exciting, isn't it?
Oh, just absolutely fantastic. I haven't had so much fun since the fish went off the bite in the Goulburn River.
And Rex, what did you think of the top award? Lisa?
Well,
she's one of yours on your station, Channel Rex. Does Kerry Stokes actually know that you own the station?
Well, I'm just about to go over there and tell him now, I think. Okay. Fire up. Have a look. You've fired up. You've had a sherry or two, haven't you, Sandy? Hey?
Oh, excuse me.
He's had a sherry.
And the flying nun is with us. Is that right?
I reckon this could be Seven's best program. You want to call this the Footy Show and put it to air, you two?
Have a look at that. The last time I saw a mouth like that, it had a hook sticking out of it. Have a
look. I'm coming on the Footy Show. I'm coming on the Footy Show.
You're coming on the Footy Show?
Gee,
we'll have to get some... You're coming on the Footy Show. I reckon there'll be about 200 others with you. Zeitgeist. Now, where'd you get that from?
It's a German word. It's the spirit of the people, Sam. The spirit of the people. It's nothing to be scared of. You are a cultural zeitgeist, whether you like it or not.
A zeitgeist.
A zeitgeist. You are. You're a zeitgeist sort of man, Sam.
B.J.B. Baby John.
How are you, Sam?
I think your career's taken off since you got the ass off that wheel, mate, to be honest. Anyhow, how's everything going? What's the most exciting story you've broken this year? Not broken, covered.
Well, we don't break them because we're a news program, but...
This is your show.
Sam, you're a legend.
This is James Packer. Now, if we
stay
think
away
we spoke...
from my girlfriend.
How are you,
Kate? Stay away from my boyfriend.
I don't even know what that means.
Here are the two biggest names in football. Eddie Maguire on Street Talk. Eddie, you're on. You're doing everything else on the show. You may as well do this.
What are you doing? Annoying people at a function like this. Why don't you stop being so crass to the people that you come and have a go at? You try to make idiots out of everybody. You should be you're a disgrace. You should be ashamed.
We felt for you when... Well, the Seven Network in their wisdom decided just to put it on in recess, the show.
Recess, that's a word. And I felt it too, Sam, and I was so glad that I could sit at home.
It had nothing to do with talent.
No, it wasn't. It was all to do with, football.
If it was anything to do with talent, mate, we wouldn't have won one. Ours is to do with shit.
I don't agree.
What about this Actors' World? That's something different, isn't it?
So
really?
Yeah.
Hang on, AutoCube. Hello? And welcome to the Logies. I'm Robert DiPiedomenica, and you're?
I'm a bloody idiot for listening to this.
I thought Eddie could have given you a chance to say something.
No,
he hogged the limelight again, didn't
Eddie
he?
Eddie runs the world, he runs the show,
that.
He runs everything.
That.
He gave you your big start at Channel X.
He certainly did.
And Tim, I want you to know that we're only Josh, and you know that because we love you.
I know that.
You do know that.
I love you too.
Grand final of Almost Footy Legends, Trevor Marmalade with the top 10 skills.
Yes, indeed, Ed. Let's go to the vision straight away here. Let's go to Doveton Eagles v Mount Waverley Catholics and full bounces by Alan Campbell here.
Has three bounces, has four. Great shepherd from Scotter. He's docked it. Great goal. The Eagles are home. Alan Campbell tops it off the captain coach with a marvellous goal. Everyone on the field is in there to celebrate that one.
And I think he's got a future as a commentator. We're looking for a big grab here from the North Wangaratta Hawk player. And very nice indeed. And can't get a bit sore too, I think, the boy there. Next we go to Myrtleford v Albury. And we're looking for a soccer goal off the outside of the left foot here. Oh, nice touch, beautiful. Bradley McPherson with the goal off the ground there. Good effort, Brad. MHSOB versus Mazenod. And we're looking for Stewie McMullen with the grab. Well done there, Stewie. That's what you call a hanger there, Ed.
Magnificent mark, that one, Trev.
All right.
The boys will have you in the van, mate, next year.
Baldwin versus Q here, and we see the young player. He kicks the ball, marks his own kick, then plays on, swings onto the right boot, and all clear. Thank you very much. Lovely play.
That's right half time, sir. It was unbelievable. This kid does everything. And, what's the jumpers?
He coaches the side and he dinks the rest of them to the ground.
Yep.
All right, Euroa v Ship United here, and a big grab. Matthew Mills, the player there. And notice Matthew sent in his own mark. Well done there, mate. Greensboro versus Mumurunthi. And we're looking for the one-hander. One-hander there by Glenn Smithers. And very nicely plucked out of the air. I think we'll pay that one.
He kicks the ball long.
And a big mark we're looking for here. And one to go on with there as well. That is
like a local footy, don't you? The bloke who gets up and hates it and just gives him one to go on with. It.
That's what you need. Bit of mongrel out there. Now we marks his own here we go, kicks the ball, marks his own kick, and then puts it onto the chest of the player. And I tell you, I wish we'd left that tape run because he actually went past with a handball and the full forward didn't give it to him. Look at that, beats his own kick in flight. And then lovely pass to the player on his own.
Our winner
for the skills part for the golf club, Stingrays versus Chargers, is the mark there by Trent Grove. Top 16 funniest legends as sent in by the viewers. Let's go and have a look now. First up, we've got the elephant kicking the soccer ball and lines it up, goes back and sticks the big foot into it. Very nice kick indeed.
A lot of people thought it was Mick Nolan, actually.
Absolutely. And a bit of footy action there from Thailand. Next, we go to our South Melbourne Districts versus North Q. And we're looking for the stuffed kick out straight to the full forward and back over his head for a goal. And South Melbourne Districts went on to win that grand final, incidentally. You'd be very happy with that. Wanderers v Waratahs, and the man on the mark we're looking at here. And just to put off the player, you'll see him reach for the shorts and pulls out the wedding tackle. There it is. And shows him the agates. And it seemed to work quite nicely. Get him right off. So much for Chewy on your boot there, Ed. All right, the big specky at the wedding got the garter tied to the football there. And not a bad leap in the full suit and the wedding clobber there. All right, here now we see the player, the Richmond player here, get the ball and go the wrong way. He's supposed to be kicking to the left of screen. He's been shepherded well by his teammate. Barnsley runs behind him, you're clear, have a shot son, have a shot, and he puts it through for a point, and then realises what he's done. Very well indeed. Next we got... Well, we saw it there. The player going for the lovely bounce there, straight into the hands of the opponent. Now, watching the kid go ass over here. Bang, there he goes. Now, yeah, here it goes. Ball comes over and... Okay, watch this. Handball straight to his opponent, who runs into the open goal. That is a sensational bit of play here. Let's just have a look at the replay. Handball's to his opponent. There he goes. And into the open goal. Now we're looking for a bit of a collision here, Ed. Three blokes go for the ball, and no one finishes up with it. Oh, unbelievable. And completely poleaxed three blokes. Now we're looking for a hard but fair bump in netball. Oh, thrill. That'll get the crowd back in netball, eh? As we see, oh, but kept the elbow down. Nothing illegal in that, I don't think. All right, now we're looking at the traditional rivals here. Swedish Helsingborg versus Danish Farum. Bit of an incident there. One of the girlfriends comes out to remonstrate with the man on the mark. And cop that. And they love their footy down there in Scandinavia.
Oh, they love it, they do.
Now, coming number five here, goal umpire we're looking for. Legendary performance by the goal umpire. Signals a point, there he is. It's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Play goes on, back over his head, and signals all clear, a goal.
Sure, he was in Adelaide a couple of weeks ago against Geelong.
In fact, I think he got relegated from that game to the AFL umpiring panel. All right, we're looking for a diving mark here from Sam, aged four. Here he goes, eyes on the ball, and nice little grab by the tacker there. And very happy with himself too. That's the way to do it, textbook, beautiful stuff. Now we've got the fullback kicking out here, kicks directly to the full forward, who then misses.
Oh, it's a shocking kick straight to Carey, he lines up for his first goal and misses.
That could go on all day. Straight to him, back he goes, easy as you like.
Oh, laconic.
And thank you very much.
Wow!
Now we're looking for a bloke here, tackled around the head, and the umpire comes in holding the ball. There's another Adelaide reject playing that one. We'll have another look at it. There he is, pole-axed to the head. Umpire runs in, it's on his blind side, directly to the front of the umpire. And pays holding the ball against you, pal. But our winner, here it is, and look at this for a rover. This bloke is a real terrier and pace. See the ball kick downfield. Looking for the rover there. There he is. And through shot. But he backs up here. Good second effort coming up. Good second effort. Racing for the ball. There he goes again. Oh, he's got the ball on the string. Absolute sensational performance. And where's the umpire? Apparently that's fair enough. No, he burrows back in. Oh, he's everywhere. Fantastic stuff.
From the producers of the Footy Show cartoon comes the editor's cut of the latest drama to hit the football scene. Young Eddie Sky Channel develop his media skills under the guidance of that old Jedi, Trevor.
Use the stats, Eddie. Use the stats.
Gee, that's a hard ball get if I've ever seen one.
He'll never get his own show this way.
Meet Sam Solo and his alien friend, Chew Duggy.
Chew Duggy, take over the controls. I'll check the engine.
You idiot.
Laugh at the antics of those lovable androids, C3B Brownless and R2 Dunstall.
Ah, hurry up, Chrome Dome!
Watch as they defy unimaginable odds.
We're surrounded by monstrous aliens.
See Eddie Sky Channel go head-to-head with Draft Vader.
You call that a weapon? Pizza! These will kill you!
The action never stops until a final showdown.
And watch out, Footy Show! It's Yibbity Yibbity time!
Only one word could describe today. It's special.
Thank your mother for the rabbits.
Footy Wars. You'll never know what hit you.
Thank you.
Onward, line of defense.
And we dress in black.
Guard against extraterrestrials.